يا أهل الكتاب قد جاءكم رسولنا يبين لكم كثيرا مما كنتم تخفون من الكتاب ويعفو عن كثير قد جاءكم من الله نور وكتاب مبين يهدي به الله من اتبع رضوانه سبل السلام ويخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور بإذنه ويهديهم إلى صراط مستقيم.
Also from the things that bring baraka to a person's money is joining the ties of the womb. Has come in the hadith of Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Man sarrahu an yubsata lahu fi rizqihi wa yunsa lahu fi atharihi falyasil rahima." Falyasil rahima. He said that whoever would like to have his rizq expanded for him and to have his lifespan increased for him, then let him join the ties of his womb. Let him join the ties of the womb. And also, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith reported by At-Tabarani in Al-Mu'jam Al-Kabir and the authority of Abi Bakr radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, "Ma min dhanbin," the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Ma min dhanbin ajdaru أن يعجل الله تعالى لصاحبه العقوبة في الدنيا مع ما يدخره له في الآخرة من قطيعة الرحم والخيانة والكذب." He said that there is no sin that Allah Azza wa Jal is more likely to hasten the punishment of a person for in this dunya, along with what he is withholding for him of punishment and storing for him a punishment in the hereafter, then cutting off the ties of the womb, and al-khiyana and treachery, wal-kadhib and lying. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam thereafter, "Wa inna a'jala ta'ati thawaban la silatu rahim, hatta inna ahla al-bayti layakunu fajaratan fatanmu amwaluhum wa yakthuru adaduhum idha tawasalu." Allahu Akbar. He said to the point where he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and there is no act of obedience that Allah Azza wa Jal is more, will hasten the reward for quicker than joining the ties of the womb. He said to the point that the people of a household, that a family, they may be fajara, they may be wicked people. They may be wicked people, and Allah Azza wa Jal will increase their money for them and increase their numbers on account of their having tawasul between one another, on account of their joining the ties between one another. And this is something, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that لَيْسَ الْخَبْرُ كَالْمُعَيَّنَ, that hearing about a thing is not like seeing it. Hearing about a thing is not like seeing it. And we see with the Arab and with the people from the lands of the Muslims the closeness that they have with their parents. Wallahi, I used to be amazed, and now it's something normal to see to me. But when I was a new Muslim, it used to be amazing to me. Many of the brothers that I was close to, they were from Iraq and they were from Kurdistan, and they were refugees, and they were from the army of Saddam. And they were in this country, and if they went back to their country during the reign of Saddam, they would have been executed. If they were found, they would have been killed. But the mother of one of them would have become sick. The father of them, one of them would have become sick. The mother of one of them would have been on their deathbed. The father of one of them would have been on their deathbed. And they would do whatever it took to get back to their country, even with a threat of death. This was something that was amazing to me. Subhanallah, we find ourselves in a selfish society, a society of ananiya. It's all about me, myself and I. that we don't call our parents, we don't speak to our aunts, maternal aunts or paternal aunts. And one narration, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, speaking about Hidan, he said that the maternal aunt was as though she took the position of the mother. Don't speak to your family. Why? Because they're kuffar. وَكَذَلِكَ كُنْتُمْ مِنْ قَبْلُ فَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ. That's how you used to be, and Allah Azza wa Jal conferred a minna upon you. A tremendous, as the ulama they say, al-minna huwa ni'matu thaqilatu al-azima. A tremendous and weighty blessing upon you. That's how you used to be. And Allah Azza wa Jal conferred a great favor upon you. We find that we don't call our parents, and that we don't keep in contact with our family. And then we cry when they die. And we can't control our emotions when they die. And we feel as though our hearts could explode when they die. And you think about your mother in the fire, and your father in the fire. لِأَنَّهُمْ أَشْرَكُوا بِاللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يُنَزِّلْ بِهِ سُلْطَانًا. Because they had committed shirk with Allah Azza wa Jal, and there is no udhr, there is no excuse for shirk. But you didn't tell them, and you weren't close to them, and if you told them, your character wasn't becoming of the character of a Muslim. And you wonder why your money is low, and why you're struggling in the dunya. Be close to the ties of your womb. Join the ties of the womb. And Allah Azza wa Jal, without a doubt, will place barakah in your money.